Good morning, everyone. It's good to see you. Clap your hands, all you people. Shout unto God with a voice of triumph. God is good. And all the time. It is so good to be here, to be in the house of God again, to worship. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Thank you so much for participating and being a part of this worship service. We now invite you to sing with us as we sing our opening hymn, Now Thank We All Our God.
First of all, I'd like to say what a privilege it is for me this morning to be in God's house with you. Our gracious and loving God, the one whom our hearts adore, we've come to rejoice on this blessed morn, to celebrate this special day in which our church, Ebenezer, was born. We thank you for those who planted the seed and for those who gave sacrificially in times of great need. We remember those persons who have labored through the years to build this, our church, Ebenezer, your house of prayer. May we follow their example of love as we desire to serve you, our God above. Like them, we seek to offer to you our best until we are called to our eternal rest. Thank you, O God, for all that's been done at this place called Ebenezer through your beloved Son. Enable us to continue our work and witness as one until our earthly race has been run. we offer the service of worship to you and thank you that by your Spirit we have been made new. May we find fresh expressions of ministry in our day as together we walk in your loving way. We offer our prayer to you in the name of Jesus, your Son, who will lead us forward in faith to the victory he has won. Amen.
I am honored to greet you today on this exciting occasion. Through tremendous faith in God, we have been given this glorious day to celebrate. This year marks 220 years of existence. We have reason to celebrate, as 220 years is a very long time. We are grateful for this opportunity that we have been granted to celebrate such a significant milestone and for the blessings that God has bestowed on our church. As we reflect on the past, we are thankful for our founders and for those who have gone on before us, for the wonderful work they did in laying the foundations for worship that we enjoy today. Today, under the theme, Honoring Our Heroes, we salute and pay tribute to members of this great church and to thank them for all they have done and will continue to do. Honorees, your commitment to and diligence in God's work have brought us this far and will continue to propel us into the future. Thank you for your unselfish service to our church and for touching many lives. We thank God for promising that he will bring our services to fruition. He started this work, and you are the hands that have continued through the various ministries of our church. Thank you, honorees, for giving to the Lord. As we celebrate this anniversary, it is my prayer that Ebenezer will commit to find ways and means to grow stronger in its outreach and mission, thus expanding our current ministries and beginning new avenues of growing our church. May our 220th anniversary be a sign of our continued commitment to unity in community as we move forward in faith. Congratulations, honorees. Congratulations, Ebenezer. May God bless us all.
We're here to celebrate our 220th anniversary. Unity in community, forward in faith, honoring our heroes. And that's why we're here today. And I now invite Mrs. Paulette Humes and Mr. Clint Higgs to assist as announcers as we honor our heroes for this morning's service. I also invite Reverend Lightburn, Ms. Cates, and Mrs. Miriam Vargas to join me at the table as we present our honorees during this first segment. After the first segment, we will be blessed with a special music by Azari Maki.
It is the distinct pleasure of Paulette and myself to serve as your announcers today, as we pay tribute to members of our congregation for their years of service through the various ministries of our church.
Earlier this year, the leaders of each ministry selected persons to be honored during our anniversary celebrations. And so today, we are excited to recognize persons who have gone above and beyond in the name of our Lord in their service to our church and community.
Our presentations will be done in four segments, and we ask that you save your applause for the end of each segment. Today, all honorees will receive plaques of appreciation. These plaques have been generously donated in loving memory of Mr. A.R. Jack and Mrs. Thelma Knowles, and they all read as follows. With our greatest appreciation, on the occasion of our church's 220th anniversary, we hereby present this award to, in recognition of your many years of faithful and dedicated service, devotion, and commitment to a particular ministry, Ebenezer Methodist Church, October 2022.
Our first segment today, we are pleased to recognize the following persons. Una Sawyer, the Women's Fellowship. Lorraine Philpott, the Women's Fellowship. Felix White, the Men's Fellowship. Allison Underwood, the Men's Fellowship. Enola Morris, the Focus Family. Marion Seymour, the Focus family. Vincent Knowles, the music ministry. We congratulate Mr. Vincent Knowles, who regrettably cannot be with us today. We invite Mrs. Juanita Knowles to receive the plaque on his behalf. Judy Sands, the music ministry. Jose Vargas, the Communications Board. Clint Higgs, the Communications Board. Let us offer a round of applause in celebration of these honorees.
Good morning. I'd just like to say a few words before I start. As we honor our members for dedicated service to church ministries, I just want to thank them for the love, effort, and strength it took to come this far. Most times we only see the face value of their works, full of smiles and wonderful fruits from their labor. But many days, they've been broken down and tired, having to keep fighting to move mountains. But no matter what, they rose up, walked it out, and did it over and over again. Thanks for having courage, bearing the weight, making the way, achieving so much, and rising up to the call. You're broken down and tired of living life on a merry-go-round, and you can find the fighter, but I see it in you, so we gonna walk it out and move mountains. We gonna walk it out and move mountains. And I'll rise like the day, I'll rise up, I'll rise unafraid, I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. And I'll rise up, high like the waves, I'll rise up, in spite of the ache, I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. For you, for you, for you, for you. When the silence isn't quiet, and it feels like it's getting hard to breathe. And I know you feel like dying, but I promise we'll take the world to its feet and move mountains, bring it to its feet and move mountains. And I'll rise up, I'll rise like the day, I'll rise up, I'll rise unafraid, I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. For you, for you, for you, for you, all we need, all we need is hope, and for that we have each other, and for that we have each other, and we will rise, we will rise, we will rise, oh, we'll rise. And I'll rise up, rise like the day you'll rise up, in spite of the ache, you will rise a thousand times again. And we'll rise up, high like the waves, we'll rise up, in spite of the ache, we'll rise up, and we'll do it a thousand times again. For you, for you, for you, for you, for you.
We welcome now our second group of honorees. And we will be giving them a round of applause afterwards, but if you feel the need to cheer on or congratulate that person as they come up, feel free. This is a celebration, but we will be doing it at the end of each group as well. We welcome first Linda Sands, the usher board. Deborah Ferguson, the usher board. Ronald Dwight, offering collection steward. Frank Williams, offering collection steward. Paulette Humes, offering vestry steward. Garfield McPhee, offering Vestry Stewart. Gary Cash, offering Vestry Stewart. Carol Sands, Communion Stewart. Gwendolyn Johnson, the Soup Kitchen Ministry. Sadly, since the submission of our honoree recipients, our next honoree is no longer with us. Today we honor Miss Agnes Johnson posthumously. We invite her daughters Karen McPhee and Desdemona Gibbs to receive this plaque on her behalf. And now let's celebrate these honorees with a round of applause.
It is truly a celebration. I wish we could have more of these services as we celebrate those persons who have given so much. And we are so grateful for all that you've given to this church, to the family of Ebenezer, to your community. We say thank you, and let's celebrate them again with a rousing round of applause. We now prepare ourselves for this morning's offering. We will sing our offertory hymn, O God, what offering shall I give? This will be followed by the offertory prayer by Ms. Kim Sawyer, and then we will get back into honoring our honorees, our heroes.
Thank you. Let us pray. With grateful hearts, Lord, we bring our tithes and offering to you. Thanking you, God, our Heavenly Father, for your many blessings, blessings of church, family, homes, jobs, our health, our daily meals. And as gratitude to your kindness to us, we say thank you. Accept our offerings, which are to further the work of this ministry and your kingdom here on earth. Amen.
We now welcome our third group of honorees. Percy Sands, Sunday school teacher. Kim Sawyer, Sunday school teacher. Margaret Roll, the Girl Guides. John Philpott, Cubs Scouts. Deborah Knowles, Cubs Scouts. We congratulate and remember Ms. Deborah Knowles, who cannot be with us today due to health challenges. We invite Ms. Janice Roll now to receive the plaque on her behalf. Barry Newbold, Decorations Committee. Sydney Pinder, trustee. We congratulate Mr. Pinder, who is not with us today, and we invite Mr. Rex Pinder to receive the plaque on his behalf. Hartis Pinder, lay preacher. Linda Pinder, Community Outreach. Earl Pinder, Community Outreach. Let us offer a round of applause to all of our honorees.
We will now be blessed with special music from Dr. Linda Lightburn.
This was supposed to be a duet between myself and Karina, and let's keep Karina in our prayers as she is not well today. But our plan B was that if she was unable, I would play my tribute. To God be the glory for the things He has done.
Let us now welcome our final group of honorees. Ashley Humes, the Youth Department. Armando Bastian, the Youth Department. Armando is presently in seminary and regrettably could not be here today. He sends his regards and sincere appreciation. Ms. Desdemona Gibbs will accept the plaque on his behalf. Giovanna Knowles Roll. On behalf of the Youth Department. Natalie Pelletier. We'll ask Charlene Newbold to accept the plaque on her behalf. Ruth Cash, Bible study and prayer meeting. Catherine K. Albrey, the Nursery Department. Miriam Vargas, the Nursery Department. Let us offer a round of applause for all of our honorees this morning.
A few persons who go above and beyond every day without any fanfare to ensure that we are able to have wonderful worship experiences. Today we wish to recognize Mr. Wayne Key, and his plaque reads as follows: with our greatest appreciation on the anniversary of our church's 220th anniversary, we hereby present this staff award to Wayne Key in recognition of 32 years of faithful and dedicated service. Devotion and commitment as church sexton. Ebenezer Methodist Church. I don't think we need to say that last part.
It is now our pleasure to recognize Mr. Barry Newbold, and his plaque reads, with our greatest appreciation on the occasion of our church's 220th anniversary, we hereby present the staff award to Barry B. Newbold in recognition of 56 years of faithful and dedicated service, devotion, and commitment as the director of music.
And last, but by no means least, we recognize the shepherd of our flock, the Reverend Milton Lightbourne, and his dear wife, Dr. Linda Lightbourne. We know that Reverend Lightborn has served with us for a combined total of 9 years.
And the plaque reads as follows: with our greatest appreciation on the occasion of our church's 220th anniversary to our minister and his wife, in recognition of your dedicated and faithful service, Reverend Milton Lightborn, we thank you for your ministry, your guidance, and your care. His greatest blessings for your life is our most humble prayer.
Dr. Linda Lightborn, when we thank God for our minister, we must give him thanks for two. For when your husband came to us, God also sent us you. This service that you perform is not only supplying the needs of the Lord's people, but is also overflowing in many expressions of thanks to God. 2 Corinthians 9, verse 12. Ebenezer Methodist Church, October 2022.
We give God thanks for all of you who have kept the ministries of our church vibrant for so many years and for your continued contributions. We are also excited about new ministries that will come about as we move forward in faith. Congratulations once again, and may God continue to bless you as you serve in his vineyard. Let's give everyone now a round of applause for their years of service.
It is indeed a celebration. We came to celebrate and to honor our heroes. So this morning I invite you again, let's celebrate with them. Let's honor them. Let's give all of them a rousing round of applause. We will now be blessed with a special music selection, a solo by Mr. Graham Thodderson. Afterwards, we will then hear the response from, on behalf of our honorees, from Mr. Garfield McPhee.
Good morning. Very quickly before I start, I want to acknowledge the fact that this is our first Sunday without a mask mandate. And a quick reminder, if you want to wear a mask, it's your choice now. It's a choice, which is great. We always love to have a choice. But if you do choose to not wear a mask, always be in mind that this also means that you have to start brushing your teeth again. Thank you.
Along the streets of gold, beside the crystal sea, we heard the angels singing, and someone called your name. We turned and saw this young man, and he was smiling as he came. He said, "Friend, you may not know me now." And then he said, "Wait. You used to teach my Sunday school when I was only 8. And every day you would say a prayer before the class would start. One morning when you said that prayer, I asked Jesus in my heart. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am a life that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so glad you gave." Then another man stood before you and said, remember the time a missionary came to your church. His picture made you cry. Didn't have much money, but you gave it anyway. Jesus took that gift you gave, and that's why I'm here today. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am a life that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so glad you gave. One by one they came, far as the eye could see. Each one somehow touched by your generosity. Little things that you had said and done, sacrifices made, unnoticed down on earth, in heaven now proclaimed. I know up in heaven you're not supposed to cry. I am almost sure there were tears in your eyes. Jesus took your hand and you stood before the Lord. He said, my child, look around you. Great is your reward. Giving to the Lord. I am a life that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so glad you gave. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am a life that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so glad you gave. So glad you came.
Good afternoon. Those who came to stand instead of the honorees in segment one, could you stand? Let me see you, please. Segment one. Who come to support those persons who've been honored this morning? Segment one. Look around. Let's give them applause, please. Segment number three. Could you stand, please, who came to support those persons in segment number three? Thank you. Segment number four, could you please stand? Thank you so much. We have a special segment, segment number two. I need to name some of the persons. not taking away anything else from, continue to stand, taking anything away from those who come to support the other segment. But I have some Baptist friends who came to stand by me this morning. Reverend Glendale Miller. Erica Johnson. Reverend Sheila McPhee. Pastor Joe Cox and his wife Doreen Cox. I have some Anglican friends. Claudette Bannister. I have another Baptist from Mount Calvary Baptist Cathedral, Colette Brown. I have Leticia Knowles, Church of God. Ulrich and his wife, Ulrich Fox Einleken, and his wife, Ulrich Tunquist. Troy Bannister, Einleken. Thank all of you. Mrs. Lorna Longley Roll, Einleken, All Saints in East Street up there. Thank you. In the book of Matthew, chapter 25 and verse 16, it reads, we are to let our light so shine that men may see our good works and glorify our Father which is in heaven. This committee, we are so grateful that you have seen our light shining. You picked us out one by one to be honored on the 220th anniversary of Ebenezer Methodist Church. We want to thank you on behalf of the committee. Thank you. We know that there are other deserving members of this congregation who you could have picked, but we were chosen at this time. May God continue to bless all of us as we celebrate Christ in our own special way. Helen Steiner Rice, one of my favorite poets, writes, and I quote, a thankful heart, bear with me, take nothing for granted, for whenever you do, the joy of enjoying is lessened for you. For we rob our own lives much more than we know when we fail to respond or in any way show. Our thanks for the blessing that daily are ours, the warmth of the sun, the fragrance of the flower, the beauty of the twilight, the freshness of the dawn, the coolness of the dew on a green velvet lawn, the kind little deeds so thoughtfully done, the favors of friends and the love that someone unselfishly gives us in a myriad of ways, expecting no payment and no words of praise. Oh, great is our loss, let me no longer find a thankful response to things of this kind. For the joy of enjoying and the fullness of living are found in the heart that is filled with thanksgiving. On behalf of all honorees, I can say thank you. God bless all of us.
Sincere greetings to you, Ebenezer family, on this special Sunday, as we honor those persons from our church who are indeed worthy of that honor. I begin my remarks by expressing our profound gratitude and appreciation to the Decorations Committee for the amazing way in which they have prepared and beautified this sacred space, for our times of worship. We've indeed this morning worship our God in the beauty of his holiness. I register my gratitude and appreciation, secondly, to the 220th Anniversary Committee for their hard work, dedication, and focus in putting today's service and next week's anniversary's service together. In spite of the challenges encountered and the changes experienced as a committee under the able leadership of Ms. Marcia Cates, you persevered and forged ahead, and your diligence, determination, steadfastness, and commitment have been rewarded. Thank you. And thanks to all of those persons who have been working behind the scenes, so many individuals, as you supported this noble endeavor. This morning's service focused on honoring our heroes. Now, often when we think of heroes, we perhaps think of great athletes, outstanding political, civic, and business leaders, courageous men and women who have fought and died in battles, medical and scientific researchers who have pushed the boundaries of medicine and science and made great strides and discoveries. Yes, they are heroes. But we can add to that list this morning ordinary men and women among us who, because of their devotion, spirit of caring, sacrifice, and generosity, and their faithfulness to Christ and his church, are also true Christian heroes. And so this morning we honor, salute, and celebrate each of you for the significant contribution you have made to the life, ministry, work, and mission of Ebenezer Methodist Church. We are indeed grateful to God for each of you, and indeed all the Ebenezer Methodist Church family. We love and we appreciate each one of you. It's because of the contribution of each one that after 220 years, the doors of Ebenezer remain open, and persons in and around this community and throughout New Providence and indeed in the Commonwealth of the Bahamas have been and are being touched. As Graham sang so beautifully this morning, thank you for giving to the Lord. Many lives have been changed, and many will rise up and call you blessed. And may our gracious God continue to bless and to keep you all, and indeed all of us, in his loving care. And may heaven's abundant blessings continue to be sprinkled and showered upon us all. I conclude with a poem which I've tried to put together for this occasion. People wonder how you keep smiling when life at times seems so hard. They wonder how you continue loving when life may have broken your heart. People wonder how you continue to give when you may be down to your last dime. They wonder how your life is lived when you have given so much of your time. People wonder how you stay so strong when trials around you abound. They wonder how you can sing a song when the issues of life, they weigh you down. People wonder how you survive when you're fighting against the odds. They wonder how you go on to thrive. It's because you have been empowered by your God. Again, thank you, and may God continue to bless you and our beloved Ebenezer Church family. And we look forward to the day when we shall march to our sanctuary after it has been completed for a service of thanksgiving, when that celebration, which has begun this day, will continue. Thank you, and God bless you.
Amen. We do that in faith. God is good. And so as we prepare our closing hymn, I ask that you don't quickly rush out. Stay. Shake the hands of our honorees. Take some pictures. Use the backdrops. And please forward those pictures to the church so we can upload it and put it on our Facebook page. So we are so grateful to all that we have honored today. And let's just give them a final, rousing round of applause. So now we sing our closing hymn, O Master, Let Me Walk With Thee.
Just before I offer the prayer, I'd like to say something. Thank you so much, Graham, for singing that song. Thank you for giving to me. It reminded me of a trip to Eleuthera, and in talking with one of a former scholar at Sunday school, he told me, he says, I never forgot the lessons I learned in Sunday school. He's now active in another denomination, but through that, persons in their mind, they know that Christ loves and Christ wants them to follow him. So he's offered himself to Christ and is willing to work for him, although not in the Methodist church there, but in another denomination. But he's very active there. So for those of you who have children that are a part of Ebenezer in particular, that they're not coming to Sunday school, we are meeting here at Sunday school. So please bring your kids out to Sunday school so that they'll get that early learning. Thank you. Let us pray. Father God, we give thanks. We worship. We praise you for the opportunity that we have. And as we look back over the years and the heroes that have passed on, we give thanks for the legacy that they've left for us, here. And we pray, dear God, that we too might leave a legacy for those coming up younger than ourselves. We give thanks, dear God, because we know that on our own we have no strength. It is you that supplies the strength that we have. It's you that allows us to come into your presence because of our Lord Jesus Christ, because we recognize that we are in a sinful body, a fleshly body. But because of our Lord Jesus Christ, you invited us to come into your presence. And we give thanks that we can come to you and offer our prayers of gratitude morning, noon, and night, giving thanks. And today, dear God, as we have gone through this service, we pray that we might leave this place realizing that we are all called to service, because you created us in your likeness for a purpose, and that purpose was to love and serve you. So may we leave this place being willing to serve you with all our mind, all our strength. So we ask you to guide us. We ask you to direct us, that we might constantly be focused upon you and the road that you have for us, even though we have different roads to follow, the traveling that we take, it's the same road that leads to you. But the ministries are different. You've called us all to a special ministry, and may we follow through on that which you have called us to do. So guide, direct, and keep us always in your care, so that we might follow your direction. And now may your love, your mercy, and your grace go with each one of us now and forevermore. Amen.
Just a quick announcement for those persons who came to honor our, for those persons who came to celebrate our honorees, we would like for you to come now and meet them and greet them, particularly